Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar, and you're watching Mind Your Decisions. It was the problem that left some of the smartest math students in the state stumped, and was described as one of the hardest problems they ever encountered, reports Pallavi Singhal in the Syndey Morney Herald. This problem was given to 17-year-old students in Australia. I tried it, and honestly, I would not have solved it in an exam. I benefited from a video explanation by Philip Liang, who was the top student in the state. I encourage you to check out the video, and there's a clickable link in the video description. So what was the problem? In triangle ABC, point D is chosen on side AB, and point E is chosen on side AC, so that DE is parallel to BC, and BC divided by DE is equal to the square root of 2. The process is repeated 2 more times. Point F is chosen on side BC, and point G is chosen on side BA, so that FG is parallel to CA, and CA divided by FG is equal to the square root of 2. Point H is chosen on side CB, and point I is chosen on side CA, so that HI is parallel to BA, and BA divided by HI is equal to the square root of 2. The segments FG and HI intersect at X. DE and HI intersect at Y, and DE and FG intersect at Z. There are two parts to this question. First, prove that DY is equal to ZE, and second, find the exact value of the ratio YZ divided by BC. Can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for a solution. So let's get started with the diagram. We need to prove that dy is equal to ze. Now, one of the reasons this problem is complicated is because it's a little bit of an alphabet soup. So one of the benefits of making a video is that I can focus on just the parts that matter for any particular step. So let's get started by focusing just on these two triangles. The first thing I will claim is that triangle BFG is similar to triangle BCA. This is because both triangles share the common angle B, and their other angles are equal because they are corresponding angles of parallel lines GF and AC. Next, we have that BC divided by BF is equal to the square root of 2. This is because the triangles are similar, and it's given that AC divided by GF is equal to the square root of 2. Now we're going to do the same sort of thing with another set of triangles. Here we have that triangle CHI is similar to triangle CBA. Why is that? Well, they share a common angle C, and the other angles are equal because HI and AB are given to be parallel. So we now can conclude that BC divided by HC is equal to the square root of 2. That's because the triangles are similar, and we were given that BA divided by HI is equal to the square root of 2. So what can we do with this? Well, we have two different fractions that are equal to the square root of 2, so they must be equal to each other. Furthermore, their numerators are both BC. This means their denominators must also be equal. So we have HC is equal to BF. Now we're going to go back to our original diagram. The next thing to notice is that this shape, DYHB, is a parallelogram. That's because the opposite sides are given to be parallel from the given information. We will also have that ZECF is a parallelogram for the same sort of reason. So now we start out that dy is equal to bh because they're opposite sides of a parallelogram. Then bh is equal to bc minus HC, we just proved that BF is equal to HC, so this is equal to BC minus BF. But BC minus BF is equal to FC, and then FC is equal to ZE because they're opposite sides of a parallelogram. So we've proven that DY is equal to ZE, and we're done with the first part of this question. Now let's go to the second part of the question. We need to find the exact value of the ratio YZ divided by BC. So on a problem like this, it's not exactly clear how to approach it and how to get to the end result, so just start out with some information that you do know. Well, we do know that YZ is equal to DE minus DY minus ZE. We just proved that DY is equal to ZE, so we can then say this is equal to DE minus 2 times ZE. Next, ZE is equal to FC because we have opposite sides of a parallelogram. We can then replace FC with BC minus BF, and we're getting closer to putting everything in terms of BC. Now recall that BF is equal to BC divided by the square root of 2, so we can substitute that in. Now all we need to do is put DE in terms of BC, but that was also given information. DE is equal to BC divided by the square root of 2. So we now factor out the BC and simplify, and we get the following expression. We then just need to divide both sides by BC so that we get YZ divided by BC is equal to 3 minus 2 times the square root of 2 all over the square root of 2. And that's our answer. Did you figure it out? Thanks for watching. These videos, available for free on YouTube, build confidence for students and inspire mathematical discovery for viewers around the world. They have over 100 million views, and we now have over 1 million subscribers. Thank you. Please subscribe for free to get the newest videos and email me a puzzle or topic at presh@mindyourdecisions.com. If you so choose, you can check out my merchandise and my books, which are listed in the video description, and you can support me on Patreon for exclusive rewards. Thanks for watching, and thanks for your support.